Well, peace and blessings, family. This is the last day of the year. So for my queen of mine, Amari, and I, we want to say Happy New Year to you and your family. May this upcoming year, may you be blessed spiritually, physically, and financially. Also, we want to thank everybody who has supported us. We created Iwapele Movement to minister to your spiritual, your physical, and your financial well-being. Today is Kaumba. Today is creativity, and this is the reason why we created this platform. We created the platform to minister to you in those areas. And so with that being said, we're praying that this ministry has ministered to you in those areas of your life. Hopefully, those of you who haven't already, hopefully you have created a business plan that will generate business-based generational wealth, and also an investment plan that would do the same. Okay, we created various ministries that has helped us monetarily, and it also it caters to the community in a nonprofit way as well. Iwapele Movement is an organization that is a nonprofit, and so you know our gift from the people is their lives being transformed into testimonials about what this ministry has done, which we have heard. So we're so grateful for all of you. Again, we're praying that you create a plan and you work the plan. Okay, you got to put in the work to make the plan work, you know. And I promise you, if you invest in yourself, okay, that is one of the greatest ROIs that you can do, is invest in yourself. Invest in your intellectual property. You know, enlarge your mental territory. Okay, that is the gift, wisdom. And wisdom is a gift that keeps on giving. You understand? So, you know, we're praying and hoping that, again, that your family and yourself will be blessed. We're looking forward to serving you here in the near future, in this upcoming year. Okay, as you all know, our attitude is servitude. And for those who don't know, now you know. All right, we're here to be a blessing to you. We've been blessed to be a blessing, and we just want to share our experiences that we have gained wisdom from spiritually and naturally, so you can live your life victoriously, and you can also enjoy this life as well. You know, I don't feel like you have to transition and go to heaven to be able to have heaven. I personally subscribe to the ideology that you can have heaven here on earth. Again, you have to create that heaven here on earth. Again, Kaumba, right? Creativity, right? You know, so that's what we want to do. We want to create that atmosphere. So hopefully this upcoming year, you have your mindset, okay, to be the creator, okay, to create the atmosphere, okay, to make it conducive for prosperity. All right. Spiritual prosperity, natural prosperity. OK, understand that joy is wealth. OK, understand that peace is wealth. Understand that your health is wealth, and understand, you know, that you being financially stable is also wealth. Again, for my queen, Imani Mari, and I, we love you all. We thank you all again for your love and support. Let's do it again this year. Hopefully some of you share and invite others so they too can be blessed spiritually and naturally as well. We're looking forward to all of us going higher. I only see higher heights, deeper depths, from faith to faith, glory to glory. Okay, I just see us all going higher. Okay, I'm an optimistic person. Okay, and I truly do believe, okay, that it's going to get better. It's not going to get worse. Again, a law of attraction. Law of attraction. Okay, set your mind on high things, okay? Set your mind on things that'll make your life greater, okay? Some people believe that this is just jibber-jabber, or it's just some cliche. No, I live by this every day. You're listening to a man who came off of welfare. You listen to a man who grew up in a broken family, but my family is whole. Why? Because I was made whole. So therefore, I was able to create an atmosphere, okay, to where the generational curse will not continue in our family. My queen became a spearheader in her family as well. You understand? So, you know, we want to help you to understand that you can live a life of victory. Okay, and this is what I'm declaring for you. that your upcoming year will be victorious, but hopefully you will come in unison with me and we'll bind our faith together. Okay. And I believe where two or three of us are gathered together. Okay. And we touch and agree. All right. And the power of the universe comes in the midst. I truly believe that it will ignite prosperity in your life spiritually and naturally. I have seen it in our life. Okay. So we are a living witness. Okay. We acquired, all praises be, within the last few years, numerous properties. Okay, we've established ministries, we established businesses, and those businesses and ministries are still alive. You know why? Because we've given life. So whatever you sow, that you shall reap. We sowed and we reaped. We gave life and others gave us life. They sold back into the ministries. They bought products from the business. And I'm telling you, family, if you just continue to toil, okay, and you continue to endure, you know, you shall reap your reward. The laborer is worthy of the hire. You shall enjoy the fruits of your labor. Okay, but you got to keep speaking it. You have to walk by faith in what you see, okay, and what you hear. Again, when I say sight, I'm talking about the vision and I'm talking about the dream. And I understand when some people say, you know what I'm saying, walk by faith and not by sight, is because sometimes doubt causes us to look at things in the wrong perspective. Okay, but in this case here, this positive scope, this positive view, okay, this eagle view that I have, that we all should have, all right, I personally feel like if you subscribe to faith, okay, regardless of what it may look like in that sense, but I want to encourage you, for those you have a vision, those you have a dream, okay, those you got a word in your spirit, listen, I say this all the time, surely it shall come to pass. Okay, I had a dream way back in let me correct myself. It was actually back in 1996. I seen me with a whole lot of stripes when I was enlisted in the United States Marine Corps. Okay, and at that time, I was only the rank of E2. Okay, I had seen me with the rank I retired at. And I retired in 2015. I got promoted in 2002. Okay, roughly 2002. Now, mind you, I seen me with a whole lot of stripes in a dream. Okay, in a dream. Let me just share this with you. Okay, because this is not some publicity stunt. I'm telling you what really happened to me. Okay? Okay, listen, I seen this in 1996. I had a dream with a whole bunch of stripes. I got promoted in 2002. Okay? You recognize the years, all of the years later, okay, that I got promoted to that rank. You're talking about 7 years later. Listen, when I was in, I seen me getting promoted to corporal. I had a dream about that. I seen me getting promoted to corporal. I had a dream, okay, about me getting promoted to sergeant. Okay, now listen, before I got promoted to staff sergeant, I want to tell you how it works in the military. What happens is you go through a selection board. Okay, they select you to that rank. And then you get promoted, but you have to wait a certain amount of time, depending on what number you have, in order for you to get promoted. Okay, listen, family. When I was in my room and I was praying, okay, for some people, they don't believe in prayer. But listen, you listen to a man who pray, and I seen that the affection purple prayer of the righteous man availeth much. I prayed, okay, and in that prayer, and I was woke, I was conscious. I looked at my collar. At that time, I was the rank of sergeant. Okay? I seen a rocker, what we call a rocker, under my chevron, which is the rank that I retired at. Okay? Now, mind you, the selection board didn't come out. My package didn't go up there yet. I seen that I was going to get promoted to the rank. I heard it just as plain as day. It wasn't no loud audible voice like it was. Okay, with the story, Moses, the ground didn't start shaking. The room didn't start shaking. Okay, it was no burning bush. All right. All right. I heard in my spirit, you're going to get promoted to staff sergeant. Now, let me tell you something. I was told to tell my supervisor this, and I was like, what? This is a true story. I was told to tell my supervisor, you know, hey, I said, you know, I said, I'm going to get promoted. He's like, well, how you know that? The list didn't even come out yet. You know, the board, no, but it hasn't even convened yet. You know, it hasn't even, you know, come together. So how do you know this, right? I said, you know, the spirit told me at that time. I said, God, because that's what I called, you know, the supreme creator at that time. I said, God told me that. Okay. Well, as you know, I told you I retired as a staff sergeant. I want to share one more story with you because see, I'm telling you, a spiritual life, understand the supernatural will put some super on your natural. That's what a lot of people lack. Yeah, some people, they get wealthy, they get rich, and they don't never acknowledge the spiritual realm. So am I saying you need that to get wealthy? No, but here's what I'm telling you. A lot of people get wealthy and they end up committing suicide. A lot of people get wealthy and they're still spiritually miserable. Why? Because they don't have a healthy spiritual life. Now back to the story at hand. I seen my son. Okay, before we even knew our son's sex, I had a dream that I was going to have a male child. Okay, my son's mother, mind you, wasn't long enough in her pregnancy for us to know that we were going to have a male child. I literally seen my son in a dream. I was asleep this time in a dream. Okay. It was like an x-ray on my son's mother's stomach. And I was able to see, like I seen all, you know, like how the organs is and everything. And then I seen my son's male organ. When I woke up the next day, I went to her and I told her, I said, we're going to have a male son. She's like, how do you know that? She's like, I'm not even far enough along. We didn't even have an ultrasound. I said, God told me. I'm telling you right now, my son will be 22 years old next year. And guess what? She couldn't even have children at the time. All the children she had, she kept losing. I prayed. I truly had desired to have a son. My prayer was answered. At one time, she was anemic. I prayed for her, and she was healed from anemia. She went to the doctor. The next time she went to the doctor told her that she looked at the female doctor looked at her, was like, what happened? Like, what did you do? She said, it's not showing up no more. Family, I'm a man of faith. I walk by faith. I make no apology about it. Keep the faith. Fight the good fight of faith. Keep holding on to your vision and your dream and the word that you heard in your spirit, for surely it shall come to pass. You may have to put in the work, but surely it shall come to pass. For my family to yours, again, may you have a happy and prosperous new year.